Good morning and welcome to the class on digital image processing. In this video lecture, I will explain you about adjacency, connectivity, regions, and boundaries. Let V be the set of amplitude values used to determine adjacency. So, amplitude values may be binary. That is, here the set V is defined as binary values 0, 1. So, it's a binary image. Or grayscale images with amplitude values in the range 0 to 255. So this is the set V. Either it may be a binary image or a grayscale image. There are three types of adjacency. First one is 4 adjacency. Second one is 8 adjacency. And third one is mixed adjacency. So here, this mixed adjacency will remove the ambiguities that are arising in 8 adjacency. Now, we will see about 4 adjacency. 4 adjacency. 2 pixels P and Q with values from set V. I will consider this set as the binary set. That is, say 0. comma 1 are four adjacent if Q is in the set 4 neighbors of P. So we should first find the pixel P, its value and its 4 neighbors. And if the pixel Q is in the 4 neighbors of P with the same value, then P and Q are said to be four adjacent. We'll see one example here. See, if I consider this particular pixel to be P and the value of this pixel is from the set V equal to 0, 1. So it is 1. Now we can consider any of the other adjacent pixels to be adjacent, and we'll verify the condition that if they are really adjacent to 1 or not. If they are adjacent, it will be having the in the 4 neighbors of P and having the same value as that of P. Now if we consider this as Q, its value is 1 and it is in 4 neighbors of P. And if you look at this particular pixel, if we consider this as Q, then this is not in 4 neighbors of P. This will fall in diagonal neighbors of P. We are interested in only in 4 neighbors of P. Similarly with this pixel. So this is also in diagonal neighbors of P. It is not in 4 neighbors of P. So here in this sub image, in the pixel representation, if you consider this as pixel P and in this one, only this pixel is in 4 neighbors of P and it is adjacent to P. Now, next we will talk about 8 adjacency. 8 adjacency. So, 2 pixels P and Q with values from V. Again, I will consider it to be a binary image. So, values will be from either 0 or 1. I'll consider the value 1, right? Are 8 adjacent if Q is in the set 8 neighbors of P, meaning which are in horizontal front and the back side of the pixel and left and right side of the pixel. So if Q is in 8 neighbors of P, then we call it as those pixels are 8 adjacent. Now we'll see this particular thing. If you look at this one, if we consider this pixel as P, and if you take this one as Q, then it is in 8 neighbors of P. So it is 8 adjacent. This is in 8 neighbors of P. This is adjacent, 8 adjacent. This is in 8 neighbors of P. This is also 8 adjacent. So if you look at here, see this one, is this pixel is having ambiguities, that is it is this pixel in 4 neighbors of P, right? And this pixel is in 8 diagonal neighbors of P. This one is in 4 neighbors of P. This one is in diagonal neighbors of P. And we are talking about 8 adjacency, that is diagonal neighbors as well as 4 neighbors. So this particular pixel is exhibiting ambiguity, means it will be in 4 neighbors with this pixel, and this pixel will be diagonal neighbors with this pixel P. So to overcome this ambiguity, we go for mixed adjacency. So two pixels with values from V are 4 adjacent if Q is in 4 neighbors of P, or Q is in diagonal neighbor of P, and the set 4 neighbors of P intersection with 4 neighbors of Q has no pixels whose values are from V. Right, this is the conditions of your M adjacency. Now see, in this one is the M adjacency. Now here there is no ambiguity. Next, we'll go for connectivity between pixels is a fundamental concept that simplifies the definition of numerous digital image concepts such as regions and boundaries. So if we understand the concept of connectivity, then it will simplify the concepts of regions and boundaries. To establish if two pixels are connected, it must be determined if they are neighbors and if their gray levels satisfy a specified criterion of similarity. So this is the condition for two pixels to be connected. Now we'll talk about the regions. So it is mentioned, let R be a subset of pixels in an image. We call R a region of the image if R is a connected set. Now we will talk about this particular thing. If you look at up to here, this is one region. See, if we consider this pixel one, its neighbor is having the same value, its diagonal neighbor is having the same value, and its diagonal neighbor is also having the same value. This is a connected set. And if you are clearly talking about the regions, then see here, coming to the bottom one, see, this one is neighbor, this one is also neighbor, this one is a neighbor, this one is a neighbor, 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 and see, this one is a neighbor. See, all these pixels are having the similar value. It forms a region with values 1. Now coming to this one, see here, all these pixels which are inside these zeros are having similar value. So this is also a region. A region of ones, and this may be a region of zeros. This is the region of ones. This is how a region. If we have, see here, this is a straight line, meaning the regions are in vertical, and the last pixel is not similar to the first pixel. If we start here, it starts from here and it forms a path, connected path, and ends again here. So this is called a connected set. So this is about the region. Coming to the boundary, is also called the border or contour, means outline of a region. Is the set of points that are adjacent to points in the complement of R. I'll just show you here. If we treat this particular, see, this one will be a region of ones. Now, if you go for the pixels which are complement to this one, meaning, so this one is the outer boundary. Coming to this particular pixels of a which is a subset of an image, of a binary image. Now see, this one will be, this one starting from here, see, this one will be boundary of the region, and the inside one, whatever the inside, see this one, these pixels form a region, these pixels all will form a region, and this one will be the outer boundary. Now I can use another terminology. See, I can have one outer boundary for this region, or an inner boundary, that will be this one, inner boundary of this region. When I say boundary, then it may be a region which is complement of the pixels which are inside, and it may be an outer boundary, or an inner boundary. Distance measures for pixels P, Q, and Z with coordinates X, comma Y, S, comma T, meaning P coordinate is S, comma T, Q coordinate is, I'll just change this one. So P coordinates are X, comma Y, Q coordinates are S, comma T, Z coordinates are V, comma W respectively. That is, given a digital image, and if you are identifying three pixels, P, Q, and Z, and their respective coordinates are X, comma Y, S, comma T, and V, comma W, right? And they may be collinear, lying in a single horizontal line or in a vertical line, or they may be randomly placed. In such a case, we can define distance, a metric, a unit to measure the distance between them. That is, distance between P, comma Q greater than or equal to zero. I will explain you when it will be equal to zero. If you are considering only the pixel P, whose coordinates are X, comma Y, and X, comma Y, if you compute the distance between the same pixel, X, comma Y, and X, comma Y, it will be, distance will be zero. And if they are not same, then you will get a positive quantity. a distance is always a positive quantity, so it will be greater than zero. If you are taking the distance with this, computing the distance with the same pixel, you are going to get the distance to be zero. If the two pixels are different, then you will get a distance which is positive, that is greater than zero. This is about the point A. Now, distance between P, Q will be exactly equal to distance between Q, P. I'll just change this one. This is Q and this is P. P. And lastly, if you consider three pixels, say P and say somewhere Q and say Z. So distance between P, Z is less than or equal to distance between P, Q plus distance between Q, Z. That is the third point. Now, given the coordinates of the pixels P and Q, we can have three different measures or distance measuring formulas. There, first one is Euclidean distance, second one is city block distance, third one is chessboard distance. Now, we will study about Euclidean distance. So it is defined as distance between P and Q is defined as Euclidean distance between P, Q is equal to this half is under root of x minus s square plus y minus t square. It's a Euclidean distance. Now, second one is city block distance. So city block distance between P and Q is defined as D subscript 4 of P, Q is equal to modulus of X minus S plus modulus of Y minus T. You need to get the absolute difference between the two coordinates and sum of them. And now we'll come to the chessboard distance. So chessboard distance between pixels P and Q, that is distance between their coordinates, is defined as D subscript 8 P, Q is equal to maximum of mod of X minus S, Y minus T. Y minus T. Right? This is about chessboard distance. In the next class, we will discuss about arithmetic and logical operations on images.